Pleasure. Marshall, welcome to Al TV. I'm sorry, should I call you Marshall or Missy?
Marshall, you know what I'm saying?
Well, Marshall it is then. Hope it wasn't out of line to ask.
No, it wasn't. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying. Because, you know, I wouldn't want you to be offended.
And I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I.
You know what I'm saying?
I told you.
You know what I'm saying?
Look,
you know what I'm saying?
I said
you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, yes, I know what you're saying, all right?
Whatever.
Anyway, thanks for being on the show. You know, we've had a lot of great guests dropping by. Have you ever met Celine Dion?
I have felt like killing her before.
Well, obviously, we all have. Ever felt like killing anybody else?
You know, most of my family members.
That's nice. Which reminds me, do you feel that you owe at least part of your success to the loving support that your family has given you over the years?
I don't owe nobody in my family nothing.
You don't owe nobody in your family nothing? Wow, that's a triple negative. Does that mean that you do owe somebody in your family something?
It's like, it's up to you to decide, you know.
Oh, I almost forgot. I know it's your favorite, so I made you a Twinkie Wiener sandwich.
I knew you'd make it, I knew you'd make it.
But before I give it to you, I just want you to answer me one simple question. What is the mathematical formula used to determine the area inside a pentadodecahedron?
It's a simple formula, it's a simple formula.
All right, what is it?
You know?
No, I don't know. What is it?
It's easy. I mean, the formula is, first of all, there, you know...
Yeah, that's what I thought. You have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, so I better just shut up.
Uh-huh. When was the last time you were completely deloused?
Last year.
Well, I've been asking all the questions here. Are there any questions you want to ask me?
You know, how many times can you rhyme, tearing me apart, breaking my heart?
Well, let's see. Homer and Bart, medical chart, strawberry tart, served a la carte, back to the start, postmodern art, plastic lawn dart, missing a part, Humphrey Bogart, lighting a fart, and blue light specials each day at Kmart! 11!
You're being a
jealous much? Hey, you know, I was wondering, why weren't you at the Academy Awards to pick up your Oscar? Was your macrame class that night?
Yeah.
Bummer. But I noticed that you did show up at the MTV Awards, and you almost got into a fight with Triumph the Insult Comic Dog. Were you afraid that a sock puppet was going to kick your butt?
You know, that was the way I felt at the time, you know.
Well, have you two patched things up, or is your rap war still going on?
Yeah, it's still going on.
That's too bad. You know, I ran into Triumph recently, and he wanted me to tell you that he thinks you're a really excellent rapper for him to poop on. How does that make you feel?
I don't know, it's like, I don't know, it doesn't necessarily hurt my feelings because I kind of expect it, you know what I'm saying?
So, tell me, Marshall, how do you feel about censorship in music?
I feel like, you know, I really believe in freedom of speech. I can't even stress that enough. I feel like, especially artistic expression, you know, I believe an artist should be an artist and be able to say whatever he wants to say, whether you think it's good or bad, you know?
Uh-huh. So you think, for example, if somebody wanted to do, oh, I don't know, a parody of somebody else's video, they should be able to artistically express themselves and just do it? I'm just busting your chops. I know you said I couldn't do a video for my Lose Yourself parody, but hey, you know, it's your choice.
Yeah, exactly. So,
just between you and me, though, don't you think my version of the song is just a little bit better than yours?
And that's kind of what pisses me off.
I knew it. Well, now I don't have a video to promote my new album, Poodle Hat, but, you know, as long as you're happy. You are happy, aren't you? You're happy, right? Because I sure want you to be happy!
You're f***ing crazy. You're crazy, for real, you're crazy.
Well, since I don't have a video for it, and since this is my stinking show, what do you say we just sit here and listen to the whole song right now?
Look, if you had one shot to sit on your lazy butt and watch all the TV you ever wanted until your brain turned to mush, would you go for it or just let it slip?
Yo,
remote is ready. Eyes wide, palms are sweaty. The Flintstones on the TV already. Wilma and Betty, no virgin. The channel surfing and I'm HD ready. So I flip. Garbage is all I'm getting. The Simon Cowell, who folks wanna disembowel. He opens his mouth, always says something foul. They're dying, wow. Wannabes are crying now. He votes them out. Time to throw in the towel. Show based on reality. Oh, the humanity. Oh, Aussie's family. Show loves profanity. Whoa, the insanity. Oh, dog fat crap and be home of depravity. No, they live happily. Yo, plus the Ali G show and celebrity mo on the Van and the Toll.
Oh, what's the matter? Don't you like it?
No, it's ridiculous, it's repetitive, and it gets on my nerves.
Eh, give me a break. I could only change the words. I couldn't change the music, too.
I just think that, it's sissy music.
Really? Well, then I imagine you'd really like it.
No, you didn't just say that, you little bitch.
Oh, come on, Marshall. You came out of the closet years ago. Don't be so coy.
That was my personal business, you know what I'm saying?
Marshall, it's okay. You can talk about it now. Do you remember what it was like when you first came out?
When I first came out, I noticed the difference, like, when I first came out. When I came out, not many people really understood me or understood where I was coming from.
That must have been tough. I have to admit, I was a little bit nervous about doing this interview.
Relax, guy. I like gay men, you know.
That's great, but I'm not gay.
I don't believe that.
Well, I'm sorry, but I'm not. What, do you find me attractive or something?
Maybe I do.
Wait, are you hitting on me?
Yeah. You don't have anything to say?
Well, I'm flattered, I guess, but I'm just really not interested. Why don't you go hit on Brad Pitt or something?
Yeah, he's cute, but isn't he married, though?
Yeah, I guess so, but look, I'm sorry if you got the wrong impression. I just asked you here so I could interview you. That's all.
What the f***? This is, you know, this is bullshit to me.
Hey, calm down. I just wanted to talk to you about your music. You know, I happen to think you're very talented, and you've got a lot of potential for growth. I see your talent as kind of a little acorn seed. And when that acorn seed is planted and watered and nurtured and allowed to grow, do you know what it eventually becomes?
F***ing tree.
Yeah. Do you think you might possibly have Tourette's syndrome?
You know, this f***ing whatever, you know.
You've got a little potty mouth, don't you?
I don't believe that nobody can not swear.
You don't believe that nobody cannot swear. Wow, another triple negative. Does that mean that you do believe that somebody... Oh, never mind. So, how do you feel about clean rappers like Will Smith?
I used to respect Will Smith. And when he came out and started talking about, you know, he dissed the whole gender of rap.
The whole gender of rap? Are you sure you don't mean genre? I don't want to second-guess you or anything. You are the Oscar-winning, critically acclaimed wordsmith and all. So, you're a big fan of the gender of rap, then, are you?
That is one of the most influential musics out there.
Very well spoken. Well, speaking of rap, we're going to have to wrap up this little interview. You know, I'm actually free after the show. Do you want to maybe go out and do something later?
We'll get some decent looking dudes and we'll...
No, Marshall, I told you I'm not into that. How about if we just go bowling instead?
All right.
Great. Well, thanks for coming on the show. And by the way, in case you didn't know, I'm just playing, Marshall. You know I love you.
Right.
We'll be right back.